Welcome to Blind School. My name is Anna. I'm a professional Russian tutor, and one of you in the comments asked me to make a video about basic phrases that you need to survive in Russian realities. Also, during this video, I'll tell you why a lot of Russian people are rude and why Google Maps wouldn't help you in St. Petersburg. Don't forget to subscribe, and let's start with the first category of phrases. In the shop, when you need to buy something, get some change, or ask how much is it. You can repeat the following phrases after me. Сколько стоит? Извините, пожалуйста, сколько стоит? Извините, пожалуйста, сколько это стоит? Можно оплатить картой? Можно оплатить наличкой? Извините, пожалуйста, можно оплатить картой? Извините, пожалуйста, можно оплатить наличкой? Можно, пожалуйста, пакет? Можно, пожалуйста, чек? The next category is in the restaurant. Можно, пожалуйста, меню? As you can see, we can use the phrase «можно, пожалуйста» again. We can use this phrase in many different situations. That's why I teach this phrase along with others, only those that you can use multiple times and that are very functional and very useful. Можно, пожалуйста, меню? Можно меню? Можно меню, пожалуйста? Извините, можно меню? Извините, пожалуйста, можно меню? When we finally ready to make an order, you can say «можно этот салат?» «Можно этот десерт?» Можно стакан воды, пожалуйста. Можно чек, пожалуйста. Можно, пожалуйста, чек. Можно бизнес-ланч по скидке. The next category is if you lost or forgot something. You can use these two words. Я забыл. Or if you're a female, you should say я забыла. И я потерял. Or я потеряла. Извините, пожалуйста, я забыл свою кепку. Вы видели ее? Извините, пожалуйста, я забыл свой кошелек. Вы видели его? Извините, пожалуйста, я забыл свою куртку. Вы видели ее? Извините, пожалуйста, я потерял свою кепку. Вы видели ее? Извините, пожалуйста, я потерял свой кошелек. Вы видели его? Извините, пожалуйста, я потерял свою куртку. Вы видели ее? The fourth situation is at the hotel. You can say the following. Вот паспорт, пожалуйста. Вот документы, пожалуйста. Извините, пожалуйста, где туалет? Извините, пожалуйста, где ресторан? Извините, пожалуйста, где бассейн? Извините, пожалуйста, где спортзал? Можно, пожалуйста, полотенце? Можно, пожалуйста, утюг? Можно, пожалуйста, завтрак? Можно оплатить сейчас? And the last category is directions. Obviously, we look at our navigations in Google Maps. But in St. Petersburg, there are a lot of arches, and sometimes the place you're looking for is inside the building. It's like in the inner yard. So Google Maps will not help you to find the exact entrance of the place. And so you need to be able to ask a stranger about where is this place is. Извините, где этот отель? Извините, где этот музей? Извините, где это? And you just say or show the name of the place you're looking for. And then you need to be able to understand what another person tells you. Идите прямо. Идите направо. Идите налево. Идите до перекрестка. Идите до станции метро. Поверните направо. Поверните налево. To use Russian in formal situations, you need to keep in mind two things. The first, Russian people are generally not very friendly or polite, but you need to understand it's a cultural thing. So if they don't smile to you, if they don't seem to be super friendly, even in formal situation, when they give you some service, you should know they behave like this not because you don't speak good Russian, not because you're a foreigner, but because it's just the way we are. We try to keep the energy for close people, for friends, for family. And that's why people in Russia don't smile much. And even if you get in some service, a lot of people can be just rude, or they can give you short answers. And it's actually very typical. The second thing to keep in mind is that everybody has different accent. And when you start speaking because of your accent, a Russian person might not understand you straight away. He needs just a few seconds to adjust to your speech. And that's why it's important to start a new conversation with the phrase «Извините, пожалуйста». It's a very simple phrase. It takes a couple seconds for you to say, and it gives enough time for the person you're talking to just adjust to your speech and understand, completely understand, the next words you're telling them. The next words you're telling him. Today we practiced vocabulary, but as you know, language consists of different aspects. Vocabulary, listening, writing, speaking. You can practice each of these skills watching YouTube videos. But unfortunately, you cannot practice speaking, because speaking, this is an experience, a real experience of you speaking, communicating. And me, as a private tutor, can help you to create the environment where you'll start speaking. So this skill will not be left behind and will be developed along with other skills. If you want to practice Russian with me one-on-one, just text me on Telegram and we'll schedule free trial lesson for you. I do academic lessons with homework, with program, and with complex approach. And also, I do 30-minute speaking sessions where we only practice speaking and concentrate on this skill alone. So don't hesitate, text me on Telegram. Thank you for watching it. Keep practicing Russian, and I'll see you in the next video. Пока-пока!